We are entering the home stretch here in the American as SMU welcomes the Owls of Temple to town, their only time to collide in conference play this year, with a potential matchup perhaps on the horizon in the conference tournament. Take a look at your standings here in a moment as the Owls and Mustangs still a chance to jockey for position in the standings. Houston will note earlier today a matinee overtime victory, have improved to 8-4. They knock off Tulane, now 5-8. But again, those coveted top four seeds still within reach for several squads as Temple on a hot streak as they have won five of their last six. Meanwhile, SMU trying to end their season on a high note with such a young group, the foundation being poured by Travis Mays. We welcome you in here on the American Digital Network. Lincoln Rose along with Coach Angela Beck. And we mentioned these two teams still a lot to play for, a lot to try to build towards going into March and into next year.
Well, Temple, as you mentioned in the beginning here, they're hot. 75 points a game in this run, averaging 41% from the field, 36% from three-point lane. That's outstanding. What SMU needs to do tonight, you know they're going to give effort. That they're a gritty team, but they are going to have to shoot the ball well in order to make this a game.
Temple's only lost during this run right now, of course, to UConn, understandably. We take a look at your keys for them to pull out another victory here on the road.
Well, they're going up against one of the best rebounding teams in the league. They got a rebound, and then they want to push and transition, make their bigs run, and then mix it up a little bit, extend their defense against them.
As for SMU, of course, well-documented by now, the youngest team age-wise in the country. How do they find success here in Dallas?
The only way to win is to be aggressive offensively, attack the basket, shoot the three when you're open, limit your turnovers, and then also defend their three-point arc because they're a great three-point shooting team.
Well, when we take a look at players to watch, of course, when you talk about Temple, you talk about a player who has helped define the success over the past 5 years. Now your graduate student, Aaliyah Butts, is back for her final campaign.
You and I got to see one of the best performances she's had all year, scoring 34 points in a game. But she averages double digits and does everything for him. Two steals a game. She had 23 points, 4 assists against Cincinnati, plus 3 steals. She's a big reason that they're here, and she's a graduate student who stuck around to make it happen.
So you go from a fifth-year collegiate athlete to a true freshman in Kayla White right here, homegrown in the Dallas area, looking to start off her career in style.
Well, I always say Kayla White never saw a shot she didn't like, and she's going to shoot it up tonight, and hopefully she's going to be close enough and hot enough to make it because she averages 14 points for them, but you know, everybody else has to contribute here. She makes it happen, but she's got to have more help.
As a freshman, she is the leading scorer for the Mustangs. When we come back, opening tip, the Temple Owls, the SMU Mustangs here in the American.
Discovery. It can come from any direction, in places new and familiar, but often starts from within.
I was the last person anybody's thinking is going to be in college athletics. One thing I really valued about my SMU experience was being in engineering school. I was taught how to think. In 2012, my wife and I decided to start our foundation. Basically, the goal is to let kids be kids while they're in the hospital, but also be able to return to being a kid when they're done. A huge part of my quality of life is the experiences that I've had, and that was all provided by SMU. I'm Thomas Morstead. Game changers are shaped here.
Inside Moody Coliseum, introductions underway. The Mustangs back in town after their quick road swing up to Wichita. We mentioned the Temple Owls now starting to collect some victories here down the stretch. They've won 5 of their last 6 after they had only won 4 of their first 15 matchups this year. Take a look at our starting 5 for both squads. For Tanya Cardoza in her 11th year, of course, you have the preseason all-conference selections in Mia Davis, the sophomore, and your outgoing senior, Aaliyah Butts, leading the way for this group, both averaging double digits on the year. And for SMU, all but one start this year made by Alicia Frawley. In fact, they were unbeaten the lone time she came off the bench against USF earlier this campaign. But a no-brainer to put the senior in your starting 5, a constant now over the past 5 years. Lincoln Rose, Angela Beck with you. for the first time today, a chance to check in with Austin Ivan courtside. Austin?
As the regular season comes to an end in less than 2 weeks, these two teams here today have a lot in common but are trending in opposite directions. The streaking Temple Owls have won 5 of their last 6 games, while SMU is struggling, falling in 7 of their last 8. The similarities: both teams are young, both teams only have 8 healthy scholarship players. Temple's head coach Tanya Cardoza said, although her team isn't looking ahead to postseason play, she knows this is the perfect time for her team to be peaking as they look to pick up another one here today.
Austin, thank you. You mentioned the skid right now for SMU. We actually had their last win on January 26th against USF right here in Dallas. It was the program's first ever victory against the Bulls program. And for Temple, of course, the difference is both these teams have a headliner outgoing senior, whether it be Aaliyah Butts for Temple or Alicia Froehling for SMU. The difference is teams can game plan around Froehling with so much youth around her. For Temple, however, Aaliyah's got a lot of backup.
Exactly. Good point, Lincoln. Absolutely. The post, you can't create your own shots. The guard's got to get you the ball. Butts makes her own shots, so that's their advantage. Right now, man-to-man defense.
Cash with the offensive rebound and put back in, SMU out in front.
Well, Cash is second leading rebounder on the team with 6.4 games, so that gets her out of the gates quickly.
Johnasia Cash started to find her stride last year as a freshman. Now as a sophomore, all of a sudden, she's one of the elder statesmen on this team.
She is, and they've shaken up their lineup a bit. You know, Whitfield's not in the starting lineup. Bacon's not in the starting lineup. They've mixed it up a bit. And that's what you do when you're not winning. You've got to shake it up and make something happen.
They'll leave room for Bacon as that shot off the mark from Imani Mayo of the Mayo Twins for the Owls.
We'll talk about this turnaround for Temple. It's been a really, really great turnaround because they've been shooting the ball well. We've seen so many teams struggle. And Temple's found their range and found their rhythm late here. And as a coach, that's what you're looking for when you put together your last run, which is the third run of the year.
So Mia Davis at the line. As again, the Owls will have a similar short bench as SMU. Davis out of Baltimore, averaging almost 20 points a ball game, just about averaging a double-double per outing these days, including her double-double against Cincinnati. The other night, 17 points, 13 boards. Best part of that possession was they got a quick foul on Alicia Froehling, and she'll hope to not pick up her second anytime soon.
What I'm a little bit worried about with SMU is that they take quality shots. They need to shoot in the 40 percentile range to be, you know, in this game, and they can't just rock and fire.
Johnasia Cash firing up the rare three-pointer. And the offensive putback will go for the Mustangs.
Yeah, big rebound for Mackenzie Ellis there at 6'2 junior.
It's just the 13th three-pointer we've seen Cash fire up this year. He's only made a couple so far. And that time in a sea of Mustangs. Lobbing on up was Marissa Mackins. Of course, her head coach, Tanya Cardoza, former UVA Cavalier in her playing days, has since become the winningest all-time head coach in Temple program history. Of course, we've seen the Owls head to 4 NCAA tournaments, 7 total postseasons under her guidance. The battle for the rebound comes down to Johnasia Cash.
And if they continue at the way they're doing, Lincoln, she's up for some kind of honors because she's really dug them out of where they were, and now they're on the streak that really no one's on besides Connecticut.
Rebound hauled in from Mackins. A win over ECU, Tulsa, Wichita State, Houston, and Cincinnati for Temple in their last 6 games. Again, the 6th opponent being UConn. And that was a trip to stores in which they fell 109-74. But they bounced back and beat Cincinnati back at McGonigal Hall. And Cincinnati's been among the more consistent teams in the league this year as we have an offensive foul, sending it back to the other one.
Yeah, that Cincinnati win's a big win for them because Cincinnati's been on such a roll. So that gives them creds going down the stretch.
And that is the first foul on Davis. Again, nice job by Mackenzie Ellis playing her first year as a Mustang, the Colorado Buffalo transfer. so able to take the charge.
So Temple's been putting up some points, 75 points a game. So they don't want to be in this, like, very slow tempo game as SMU's starting to kind of do a control the clock kind of thing.
Kayla White able to drop that one in as one of the handful of freshmen this year for Travis Mays able to come through again. She's been a constant for the Mustangs. Out of DeSoto High School, south of Dallas. Actually signed with her cousin, Ja'Kia White, both freshmen this year. Both were in high school together as teammates. As John Asia able to get her right hand on that one for the block.
Well, excellent defensive effort by SMU. There were four players converged on the ball there with Davis and swatted it from behind.
Able to deny Shantae Taylor on the opposite end. Cash, they double down on her. Still takes the shot. Too many numbers for Froling to overcome for the rebound. A long three-point effort off the mark from Mackens. And another rebound here early on for John Asia Cash.
Well, Cash has come to play. I think Coach might have gotten in her ear and talked to her a little bit about her presence and what they need. And she's looking good here early.
It's already four boards for number 33. Oh, nice dish to Froling. Mackenzie Ellis able to stay in bounds and pick up the assist.
And Mackenzie Ellis getting a lot more minutes here late in the season.
We've got a pair of sister tandems, and, well, if somebody had been paying attention, could have been a turnover there. Everybody just going through the motions at the moment. Ball recovered by Ja'Kia White. Again, each team with a sister duo. SMU also with a pair of cousins.
Yeah, Ja'Kia White really wasn't getting any time early on this season, and she's really worked her way back into being a major player for them.
Cash mid-range with three to shoot. White with the putback. That one won't go. Again, that was Kayla White. And we've got a tie-up now. So, of course, if you've been following this conference, naturally, the team that's been red hot, struggling against a team that hasn't found any luck go their way. It's yet another evening in the American. Gives us a chance here to check back in courtside with Austin.
Thanks, Lincoln. If you're just now joining us, I want to welcome you to Inside Moody Coliseum, where SMU hosts Temple. We love that if you can't make it out to the game here in Dallas, you get to watch with us on the American Digital Network. So let us know in the comments below where you're watching from and who you're cheering for, because we love interacting with you, and we will be throughout the entire game.
Austin, thank you again. A chance to hear from you in the comments. We'll have some trivia coming your way throughout the broadcast as well. Right now, the Mustangs out in front here in Dallas.
At the American, we know that power isn't for the faint of heart. Power is reserved for the go-getters, the team players, and those who are hungry for victory. We know power because we are power. Join us for the 2019 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship, March 8th through the 11th at the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut.
For a fourth straight year. Queso from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate this type of championship.
There's the record breaker. They are the champions of the American.
Powerful minds, strong in mind,
strong in body.
The American is dedicated
to promoting success
through a healthy, powerful mind.
If it is okay to seek help
for injuries we can see,
then it needs to be okay
to seek help for injuries
we can't see.
Mental health awareness is important because I think a lot of times it goes unnoticed in college athletics.
We look after our bodies, and it's just as important to look after our mental health.
It's time to end the stigma
related to mental health
and seeking help.
End the stigma.
Ideal start for Travis Mays and the Mustangs. Thanks in part to offensive rebounding, defensive rebounding. John Asia Cash leading the way with her four boards. Travis Mays, the former Texas Longhorn, went on to play in the NBA. Longtime successful assistant coach from some of the greatest women's basketball coaches over the past few decades. And he took his time finally sliding over to the final chair when the SMU job came open. He decided to happily, 3 years ago, accept this opportunity with the Mustangs.
Yeah, 16 years as an assistant and now the head coach, and it's his show, and he's building it from the bottom up.
Jonte Taylor called for the offensive foul. Again, both these teams fairly shallow benches, and as a result, fouls, when they accumulate, can certainly hinder them a little more so than the average team. This is Ja'Kia White off the bench, the lone player so far that Travis Mays has gone to. And a nice stroke from Mackenzie Ellis, who looked like she was ready to rebound a miss. No need.
Yeah, Mackenzie Ellis for the year, 4 of 22 for 18% from three-point range, but that one looked pretty smooth.
Yeah, just her fifth triple on the year. Froehling, that's her second foul now.
Ooh, not good. Really devastating for SMU. They cannot have Froehling on the bench this early.
See how Travis Mays handles this with a nine-point lead.
Yeah, with that lead, that's not real smart of the senior.
It's her instinct kicking in. She is the all-time leading shot blocker, 200 in her career at SMU. Mackins, though, that is the freshman able to get the fifth-year senior to bite.
Yeah, I think that she probably would say, Froehling would say that that's not really a foul like she usually does, but a little touchy touch, but...
Not in Queensland, maybe.
Yeah. Well, of course not in Queensland.
As move inside, off the mark from Bree Tolley, the freshman who comes on for SMU. How about this? If I don't say what year they are, you just assume that they were at their high school prom last year.
Yes, correct.
And another player control issue, a charge called on Temple. SMU making things happen defensively.
Well, SMU is dialed up. They came to play. They came to play defense. Look at the eyes right there on Janasia Cash. She has really been focused and been a big part here early on.
That's now two fouls on Shantae Taylor, both of them charging calls.
Well, I guess memo's out. Like, she's going to go hard and just stick your ground.
The junior coming off a double-double against Cincinnati, 12 points, 11 rebounds, even had three blocks in that one. Big part of that win for Temple. Aaliyah Butts really helped carry them across the finish line, scored double digits in the fourth quarter alone, and Tolley with the turn.
Well, I like that a lot. It's a 1-4 high set where they run a high-low. She spinned to the outside where there wasn't any help and used the up and under.
Earlier this year, Travis Mays, big expectations for Tolley, but says at times she just overthinks things. That time just did what came naturally.
It was perfection in motion.
A little pull-up 15-footer from Aaliyah Butts trying to get Temple on track.
Well, first field goal here of the night, and it's going to be Butts that's going to make it happen. If she starts getting going, watch out.
It started 0-for-6, and consider Bree Tolley unimpressed. Her second field goal alone has SMU out to a double-digit advantage.
Well, 16-5 lead here early. That's a great start.
Tolley makes her first triple. SMU now 2-for-4 from downtown Big D. White, and they're going to get her for the offensive foul. Aaliyah Butts takes the charge.
Yeah, in that situation, White was a 1-on-2. She should have stuttered and held up. There wasn't anything there. She's got a veteran, graduate student there, taking the charge. So that would have been, that's a little bit ill-advised take.
Aaliyah Butts, just like Alicia Froehling, when they step off campus for the last time, they're going to have a lot of records with their names by them. For Froehling, already the leading rebounder and shot blocker. Alicia, in all likelihood, will finish among the top few scoring in program history.
A That's five early turnovers for Temple, which is not, they're not a big turnover team, so that's a little surprising.
Rolling right now, sitting at number four, but number three is certainly in reach. While Aaliyah Butts, all-time leading three-point make for Temple. And she'll look on as her teammate Davis is able to chime in.
Well, that's Davis there. She has 27 threes for the year. Just make it 28. She says, I'm not only an inside player, but I can do it all. I can rebound and score from three.
Yeah, Mia was one of Tanya Cardoza's picks as obvious most improved this year. Really expanded her game from beyond the arc. And a rare miss early on off the bench from Tolly. Already down to single digits. Offense rebound, put back, and Temple will take more of that, please.
Yeah, that's Shantae Taylor there with the put back. Or that's Mia Davis, I'm sorry.
Yeah, Davis, who almost averages a double-double per ball game. 17 points, 13 boards in that Cincinnati win. Able to work it inside, and SMU is getting just about everything to click. They find Paige Bayless, their 6'5 target down low.
Watch out if SMU gets the high-low game going. That's their bread and butter.
Open from the wing. Travis Mays was the nearest Mustang on that one, but it won't go down.
A one and done is what SMU does to you. One of the best rebounding teams in the American. You're not going to get two.
For a while there, SMU had been getting off almost two shots for every one taken by Temple. Temple's rebounding has improved a little bit as of late. But SMU still getting second chances here early on. Not getting a second chance, the suit jacket for Travis Mays. It's already off. Bow tie still on.
Well, at least he has his bow tie on. We watched a game where he did not have the bow tie on, and it was actually crushing.
Did not make it out of the locker room. As White will get her own miss. Shot clock still a factor here, about 3 seconds separating the two. Squares up, and on the mark, Kayla White.
Well, you always know when Kayla White's going to shoot it because it's just a rock and a fire. There's no hesitation.
Temple down by 10. The final look, and may get some free throws. No, they'll say foul on the floor.
Well, so far, what a great first quarter by SMU, 20 points. I mean, they're not a big scoring team, so for them to get 20 in the first quarter is quite amazing.
Only negative has been Alicia Froling picking up two fouls. Same can be said for Temple with two quick fouls on Taylor. See if they reemerge in the second quarter at some point. Butts to beat the buzzer. And SMU will take a 10-point lead into the second frame of this one. Mustangs back at home, looking to get back into the win column.
Strong in mind, strong in body, strong in school, sport, life.
The grind is 10% physical and 90% mental.
The mind is the power.
The body is a means to jump higher, run faster,
be smarter and live longer.
There is no weakness when it comes to seeking help.
We are stronger together.
So let's talk about it.
A waterfall starts with one drop.
Change starts with one person.
The American is dedicated to ending the stigma related to mental health.
And promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination. This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination.
Ten minutes in the books. About to put a fresh 10 minutes on the clock for the start of the second quarter. And a chance for us to quickly check back in with Austin Ivan.
Thanks, Lincoln. Sophomore Mia Davis has had career back-to-back games for Temple. On February 2nd, she tallied 30 points against Wichita State, which was her career high. And then 3 days later, she topped that, scoring 33 points against Houston. So our trivia question for you today is, how many games this season has Mia Davis scored at least 20 points? Let us know in the comments below if you think you know the answer, or give us your best guess. We want to know what you think. We'll let you know later on in the game what the correct answer is.
Austin, thank you. Mia already off to a great start. 7 points early on, including making her lone triple. Also has 4 rebounds. Saw that in the first 10 minutes. Did not come out for a breather. And they'll need more from her. What about that tandem?
Well, that tandem is double digits, 119 and 113 points. And that's hard to come by. So that's a tough double team to beat, you know, with that kind of offensive power.
They both had themselves a night when we saw them against Tulsa. So again, Froehling does not get the start in the second quarter with her 2 fouls. Same can be said for Taylor for Temple. Doesn't matter, another Australian willing to step up. It's Paige Bayless.
Yeah, Paige Bayless she's becoming the go-to for them now. And you can tell coach is starting to rely on her. She's only a freshman.
Temple just 3 of 12 from the floor so far. Make it 3 of 13, the rebound for Bayless.
6'5", why not? I mean, she shows a lot of agility and abilities at that size.
Paige last year played for the Australian U18 team. Her family knew the Froehling family, which of course over the years has produced 3 different Mustangs, including Alicia's twin Keely, who's now already playing professionally back home. And as that one thought about it, wouldn't go down. Finally the rebound for Lena Neon. Lena making her 19th appearance off the bench this year. As that one falls in the lap of Ellis for the rebound. SMU up by a dozen, matching their largest lead so far.
Well, great rhythm, great team chemistry so far. Probably one of the best quarters I've seen them have.
As Bayless will be called for taking a step before putting the ball down. Just the 3rd turnover for SMU so far. Well, obviously SMU's been capable of this kind of play for most of conference play, but it is all clicking right now. With that said, Temple has had their fair share of battles. And of course, they've been more often than not on the winning end of them when it's all said and done.
Well, when you're so young like this and you have such a big game, every game's big, obviously, but they've got 5 losses in a row, so they're just trying to bury it and get as many points as they can and just keep drilling down.
Kayla White never got her hand on that basketball, but she forced the turnover for SMU. Able to cut off the individual after catching the basketball. Tanya Cardoza sees for Temple the Owls' 6th turnover of the ball game.
I don't think Tanya Cardoza's too upset yet. I think she knows that this is a game of runs and that SMU came out with a lot of enthusiasm. It's hard playing on the road, although she does understand her team has only won 3 road games this year. So it's perplexing as a coach when you have such great talent around you like Butts and Davis, but you're still just wondering what they're going to do on the road.
Mid-range won't go. John Asia Cash back in the ball game and going right back to the boards. Already number 6 in 8 minutes of play for John Asia. Ball danced around. Ariana Whitfield getting the home court roll, the sophomore.
Yeah, Whitfield not getting the start tonight. I think she's just coming out a little bit more aggressive than I've seen her in the past.
It's the 4th time she's come off the bench this year, but SMU can do no wrong early on. Their largest lead now at 14 here in quarter number 2.
discovery. It can come from any direction, in places new and familiar, but often starts from within.
I was the last person anybody's thinking is going to be in college athletics. One thing I really valued about my SMU experience was being in engineering school. I was taught how to think. In 2012, my wife and I decided to start our foundation. Basically, the goal is to let kids be kids while they're in the hospital, but also be able to return to being a kid when they're done. A huge part of my quality of life is the experiences that I've had, and that was all provided by SMU. I'm Thomas Morstead. Game changers are shaped here.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save, a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student-athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American, power for life.
Back at Moody Coliseum, this is the only matchup this year between these two teams. Last year they met twice in the regular season, each time the home team won. The second of the two meetings in Philadelphia. Mustangs trying to prevail once again here at Dallas. Another chance for us to check back in with Austin.
Thanks, Lincoln. You mentioned that Temple has had some ups and downs throughout the season. To start the month of January, they lost 7 games straight. On that next game, senior Aaliyah Butts decided she wasn't going to wear her knee brace on her right knee that she's worn all season long. Temple won that game and since then has won 5 of their last 6 games because Butts hasn't been wearing that knee brace. So, Lincoln, Angela, some players have good luck charms, but maybe for Butts, her knee brace was a bad luck charm.
None of us want to give medical advice, but Aaliyah, it turns out, so far, so good.
Well, it's more mental than physical at that point, and she just wanted to shed anything that was, taking her down and be the player that she's capable of being.
Again, it's the reason why Aaliyah is suiting up this year, because she had to sit out last year with that injury. Second chance opportunity here for her Owls.
Yeah, it's a nice offensive rebound there by Perry.
Nice job inside, able to get around Cash and work it ultimately into Alexa Williamson.
Good hands there. One-handed stab on that.
Alexa's from Houston, but Houston, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, not the Houston that we know.
Nice quick release from the wing. Tad Strong. White with the rebound. Won't go. 0 for 2. And Williamson with another rebound. Both the Temple's freshmen that played this year have taken turns as freshman of the week on the season. Williams got the honor back at the end of December. And, of course, more recently, we've seen her teammate Marissa Mackins get it a couple weeks ago.
It's impressive to watch Janasia Cash, her development. That she's really gotten a lot stronger, a lot more confident as the season's gone on, and she's been a big player for them.
White trying to feel a rhythm as Neon hauls it in. Aaliyah Butts drew 4 Mustangs defensively around her to create the open look, but unable to take advantage that time, Mia Davis. Cash. And let's see what the call is. It's going to send it back over to Temple.
Yeah, that's what I thought. 3-second violation there. I like the last transition by Butts. This is a little high-low. Not sure where the 3-second was. It's usually once you gain possession, you get another 3. But I like it when Temple's pushing transition rather than just walking it up.
We'll stay on this end. Right now, Temple's shooting just 21%, 4 of 19. Mustangs 42% from the floor here in the opening half.
Yeah, controlling the boards, that's what SMU's doing. Great defensive effort by Tolley there, just to come around and tip that out. Shows her athleticism.
Again, we still haven't seen Alicia Frawling nor Shantae Taylor return for their two teams after picking up two fouls in the first quarter. Tolley had an arm held back, and that is going to go against Temple. It'll be on Williamson. Trying to deny her the rebound. Bree Tolley out of Florida, went to Montverde Academy. That's a school that has produced, at least on the boys' side, quite a few lottery picks for the NBA over the years, including Joel Embiid and Ben Simmons.
That's Butts giving White a little bit of her defensive pressure. Butts has got two steals a game, and she is a defensive stopper for the Temple Owls. So giving it all she's got here on her last year in the American.
SMU right now in the midst of a drought. Let's see if Temple can take advantage, start chipping away at a 12-point deficit. And Cash is able to sell the foul this time. It's another offensive foul on the Owls.
Well, in the opening, I talked about SMU being gritty. This is what we're talking about. Little bit of grit from the big girl taking the charge.
That's the second whistle on Davis this half now. And you wonder if Tanya Cardoza will gamble, down by 12 already, and just trust Davis not to pick up number three before halftime.
I doubt it. I'm going to say no. Just a gambling person I am.
And you know what? The foul they have on Mackens.
I think she's going to trade her for.
That's Ja'Kia White with a triple off the bench.
Well, that's a big, big three for them. Now, I think as long as you got Froling on the bench, she'll keep Davis on the bench.
Three different Mustangs have connected from beyond the arc today.
Well, I think the difference I'm seeing in SMU is they're playing some defense. They're getting excited. They're showing intensity on this end, which they've been kind of lackadaisical this year. It's impressive.
And I will go back to my initial statement that Davis did, in fact, pick up a second foul. It briefly put that on Mackens, but it was 25 instead of 5. Timeout right now by Temple, down by 15. We give you another glimpse at the standings. Again, these coming into today, we've already had at least one game go final, a rare matinee where Houston went to overtime against Tulane. We've seen Tulane lose some tight ones while Houston is hanging on to a top four seed. They're tied with Cincinnati at 8-4. Of course, they were perfectly okay with Temple picking up that win against the Bearcats the other night.
Absolutely.
And there's a little two-game buffer now between the top four seeds in the middle of the pack. Temple still only 2 points here in the second quarter as SMU has been able to grow its lead.
Well, I think it gets down to shooting the ball. Where we talked in the open, Temple shoots the ball at 41% in these games they've been winning. This is not a good start for them at 20% from the field.
Open look. And Cash denied what would have been her eighth rebound of the half. Davis into the lane, no. And now SMU whistled. That'll be the third team foul on the Mustangs. Still no free throws. Temple trying to snap a 3-minute scoring drought.
Yeah, they're just trying to figure out who actually fouled her. I think it was Ja'Kia White, but I'm not sure who they tagged that to.
Step back from Aaliyah Butts won't go.
Well, that's a big difference maker right now. She's not hitting her threes like she has been. Once she starts connecting, though, she's extremely streaky, and she could fire five of them off.
Aaliyah's just 1 of 8 from the floor, 0 for 4 from downtown here in this first half. You see the numbers for the teams. Shot clock down to 5, straight away from Ellis. And what looked like it should have been an Owls rebound, SMU does not give up on it. And you talk about quality minutes off the bench from Ja'Kia White.
Yeah, she's been getting a lot more minutes and been proving herself as the season's gone on. She got the start.
As Ja'Kia making her fourth start of her young career. Cash, double teamed.
That's kind of a bailout call there. She got double teamed.
It was after her shot, Brianna Perry.
Yeah. Little double team and kind of threw it up there. So if that was a foul there, not a good one because she didn't have a chance in heck.
They're actually saying the foul was on Mackins. So Mackins now becomes the third Owl with multiple fouls. Let's see if they are reviewing which player committed the foul. And they are saying it was, in fact, on Mackins. Freshman out of Durham, North Carolina. Had a nice outing. She was 1 of 4 Owls in double figures in that win against Cincinnati. Had 12 points.
Yeah, just a little spin in here. She doesn't really square up. Little belly up. I call that a body up. I mean, there's not a lot there, but... Like I said, it's a little bit of a bailout, but good for Janasia.
If you're shooting that ball, you certainly think that's the right call.
Yeah, absolutely. Anytime a body hits you,
feel it.
Yeah, you want it.
A cash miss is the front end. One more for Janasia, 54% shooter from the line.
You kind of wonder if Coach Mays is building his team around Janasia Cash now. You see, like, the next generation coming in. She's been the go-to tonight, and she's been, actually the leader. So I think he sees a lot in her, and I think she's going to be a player of the future.
16-point advantage for SMU. Cash denies the entry feed, stays with Temple. And a nice stroke from Lena Nayan. Well, we don't talk about this senior quite as much. Now in her second year, the transfer from North Carolina State a couple years back.
Yeah, she averages 5 points, but she can come in and dial it up a little bit.
Shot clock halfway down. And they'll say that one last touched by Whitfield after 4 Owls had gathered around her.
Yeah, Whitfield was just kind of pressing her offense just a little bit. She got a little deep in the pocket there, and if you break that free throw line extended, you got to have someplace to go, and there was nowhere to go. She got tripled up.
Temple already more conference wins than they had last year when they went 3-13, but again, they were one of many teams that actually found success in the first round of the conference tournament. That was a tournament full of upsets on day one. Another reason why you want to be a top 4 seed. You just never know what's going to happen that first day, and then if you're a top 4 seed, the team you're facing then in the second round has played in the past 24 hours. Cash able to drop it through.
Wow, that was smooth, like very smooth. Mid-range, 18-footer there for the big girl.
Tanya Cardoza's squad beat Wichita State last year in the first round, then would fall to UCF in the quarterfinals. Well, baseline shot is going to ultimately fall through for Mia Davis this year. Picked preseason second team all-conference.
What's impressive, her range of game, though. She can shoot a three. She has a mid-range jumper. That's a little mid-range jumper. She can back you up and take you down, and she's a good free throw shooter. So there's a lot of things she's doing well, plus rebounding. Complete game.
Well, Imani Mayo's called for the foul, so after the positive with the score, you now have your fifth team foul, which is going to take you to the opposite end and give SMU some free throws. Woodfield, an 81% shooter from the line. And Whitfield's been giving Travis Mays about 30 minutes a night out there on the court.
Well, like we expected, SMU rebounding-wise has got 23 boards to Temple's 14, and that's a big part of what you're seeing right now. They're really limiting them to what they can do. If they take a shot, and there's a steal right there.
Whitfield unable to give SMU their largest lead so far. And on the opposite end, in transition, no.
Oh, wow.
Kia White winning over the fans with the block.
Oh, my gosh. That's a big block there for the little girl.
As we approach the final minute. Tolly. And another battle for the loose ball.
We talked about the grit. We talked about how SMU plays. Well, here you go. From behind, take it out of here. It's my house, not in my house today.
Ja'Kia White listed at 5'8". Aaliyah Butts listed at 5'4". Ja'Kia White probably felt like she was Yao Ming right there.
Absolutely. She was sitting on the bench for a good part of the beginning of the season. Now she's alive, and look what's happening.
We need to teach our camera operators to really sell that. Get low and make them look like the towering athletes on plays like that.
Oh, yeah.
By the way, want to mention a big thank you to our entire ADN crew. This is the final game of our regular season coverage. Lots of other great TV partners will take you the rest of the way over the next couple of weeks to close out conference play before the tournament up in Connecticut in March. But big thanks to all the men and women around the country who have helped bring us these contests. Well, they just denied Temple some points in the paint. SMU's found some success early and often.
Well, there you go with Cash with a little turnaround jumper coming from behind Ellis. Just a little putback action in the paint and then toss it back to our girl in foul trouble there, Alicia Froling. Just everybody uniting and getting it to each other. A little high-low game for Bayless. So when they get their high-low game going and they get their guards in the paint, they're really difficult to hold.
Travis Mays has played 8 players tonight. All 8 have scored. In fact, Alicia Froling has the fewest points. She's the only player with just 2 points for SMU tonight. So every storyline, just put a check by it, absolutely as we expected.
Yeah, you just expect the unexpected in the American Athletic Conference, except for UConn.
I mentioned SMU's last win was at the end of January against USF here in Dallas, and that's the only game this year Froling didn't start. Travis Mays really just wanted to remove what everybody would assume is always the constant and force someone else to try to step up early. Of course, Froling's been double-teamed all year long. Bayless, her country mate, gets the rebound there.
I mean, nothing tricky on the defensive end. Both teams just in a solid man-to-man defense. And pretty predictable to what we expected.
Alicia Froling is going to have sat the final 14 minutes of this first half, ready to go in that third quarter. And her teammates, in her absence, have continued to grow this lead at 15.
Well, she and Davis have both been on the bench, which is a big storyline for us.
3 different Owls since then have picked up multiple fouls. Davis still playing. Mackens and Taylor on the bench. There's Davis unable to hit. Has to be careful not to pick up that third foul right before the buzzer. So one half of basketball in the books. Lone meeting this year between SMU and Temple. And it's SMU heading to the locker room up 32-17. We'll look to have a chance to talk to Travis Mays before Mustangs head into the locker room. But he has to be pleased with just about everything he's seen tonight. He may not tell his players that. Travis is now with Austin. Let's check in with those two.
Coach, your team started off hot and has built a 15-point advantage. How do you make sure your team extends their lead in the second half?
Well, I'm going to just go in there and congratulate them all and reinforce all the details that we're executing and we're running our offense. We're controlling the tempo right now. We're playing together. We're playing connected. And it's fun to watch. And I asked them on the sideline, it has to be fun to play. Everything is easier. We look connected as a team, and I like watching that.
Aaliyah Butts has only scored 2 points for Temple. Defensively, how have you managed to keep her in check so far?
Well, our number one focus is to have five people guarding the ball on her. We know we got two very explosive scores. And even though we have them at 15-point lead right now, they can get hot on one or two turnovers or bad shots that we take, and it can have a real game on our hands. So we're going to try to come out in the second half and look at the score and assume that it's 0-0 and try to win the second half.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Austin, thank you. Travis Mays going conservative there, not playing a sixth defender on Aaliyah Butts, but so far so good. SMU with a 15-point lead midway through. When we come back, take a look around the league and first half highlights and stats.
Discovery. It can come from any direction, in places new and familiar, but often starts from within.
The conference opponent I like playing the most is obviously UConn, because it's always will be like a great battle. My dream baseball career is over would be like maybe an FBI agent. Right now I'm going to school for criminal justice. The emoji I use the most is kissy face.
Can you do an impression, Coach?
You guys need to settle down on defense! My secret talent is I can do hair. My best friend on the team is Desiree Oliver.
What are you listening to in your headphones in the pregame?
Dreams and Nightmares by Meek Mill. It means a lot to fit on my school jersey because, like, I'm not only representing myself, but I'm representing others, my teammates, my coaches. So it means a lot. See you. Go Owls.
I was the last person anybody's thinking is going to be in college athletics. One thing I really valued about my SMU experience was being in engineering school. I was taught how to think. In 2012, my wife and I decided to start our foundation. Basically, the goal is to let kids be kids while they're in the hospital, but also be able to return to being a kid when they're done. A huge part of my quality of life is the experiences that I've had, and that was all provided by SMU. I'm Thomas Morstead. Game changers are shaped here.
Do you have a nickname?
I have Afro, so my first initial and my first part of my last name. And I'm a twin, so Afro, my sister's K-Fro.
What emoji do you use the most?
Probably the little laughing face emoji. I think that I'm two different people, one on the court, one off the court. Off the court, I'm silly, goofy, and then on the court, I'm pretty serious, down to business, and a hard worker.
What's the last thing you Googled?
I Googled how much liquid I can bring onto an airplane in from ounces to milliliters, because I'm still getting used to the American system.
What does it mean to you to put on your school's jersey?
It means so much, I guess, especially being my last year. You know, I'm just going to take pride in that every time I put it on. SMU, pony up.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save, a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right. There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
Strong in mind, strong in body, strong in school, sport, life.
The grind is 10% physical, and 90% mental.
The mind is the power.
The body is a means to jump higher, run faster,
be smarter, and live longer.
There is no weakness when it comes to seeking help.
We are stronger together.
So let's talk about it.
A waterfall starts with one drop.
Change starts with one person.
The American is dedicated to ending the stigma related to mental health.
And promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
Promoting success through a healthy, powerful mind.
At the American, we know that power isn't for the faint of heart. Power is reserved for the go-getters, the team players, and those who are hungry for victory. We know power because we are power. Join us for the 2019 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship, March 8th through the 11th at the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut.
Halftime in Dallas, Mustangs as well as Owls back in the locker room gives us an opportunity here on the American Digital Network to again get you updated on some other news and notes from around the league. And of course, each week the conference releases its Player of the Week and Freshman of the Week. And this past week, for a second straight week, it's Nafisa Collier.
Well, she's amazing. She's going for the Player of the Year honors. Senior for UConn. She's just perfection in action. She averaged 30 points last week, 16 rebounds. Against UCF, she had double-doubles. She's just doing everything for them and making it happen.
Nafisa is now your Player of the Week in the American 3 of the past 4 weeks, 4 times overall this season. And, well, your Freshman of the Week in the American, don't have to look too far, her teammate, Kristen Williams.
Well, Kristen Williams is saying, hey, but what about me, coach? 19 points, 7 of 8 shooting from the field, 12 points against UCF. In the third quarter, she had 3 rebounds, 2 assists, and made it all happen for them, and it all in one quarter. He didn't give her too much playing time, just that quarter.
Kristen Williams, your Freshman of the Week. Nafisa Collier, your Player of the Week here in the American. Congratulations to both when we come back to Dallas first half highlights and stats. Dominance for a fourth straight year. Quacho from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate this type of championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Powerful minds.
Strong in mind.
Strong in body.
The American is dedicated
to promoting success
through a healthy, powerful mind.
If it is okay to seek help.
For injuries we can see.
Then it needs to be okay
to seek help for injuries we can't see.
Mental health awareness is important because I think a lot of times it goes unnoticed in college athletics.
We look after our bodies, and it's just as important to look after our mental health.
It's time to end the stigma
related to mental health
and seeking help.
End the stigma.
More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination. This is our game, our moment, our time. We work hard and play harder. We stay loyal to the game and to our team. We are power, American power. The American, powered by determination.
Discovery. It can come from any direction, in places new and familiar, but often starts from within.
Big changes are on the way.
I was the last person anybody's thinking is going to be in college athletics. One thing I really valued about my SMU experience was being in engineering school. I was taught how to think. In 2012, my wife and I decided to start our foundation. Basically, the goal is to let kids be kids while they're in the hospital, but also be able to return to being a kid when they're done. A huge part of my quality of life is the experiences that I've had, and that was all provided by SMU. I'm Thomas Morstead. Game changers are shaped here.
Our coverage continues here in Dallas inside Moody Coliseum. Mustangs and Owls starting to reemerge from the locker room, just about ready to go for the start of the second half. Lincoln Rose, Angela Beck with you. And while we take a look back at some of the key moments in that first half for SMU, Alicia Froling, a quick two fouls, not an issue for the Mustangs. Total team effort despite the quick start from Temple.
Well, it was a team effort. It was all of them contributing. You got Whitfield, you got Bayless, Tolley, and White all making their deal on offense, getting charges on defense and scoring offensively. There, you know, you've got Froling right there getting easy two, but it was great team chemistry. Their defense was outstanding. They all actually had a lot of enthusiasm, which I hadn't seen for a long time, and they're making it happen.
We saw Temple pick up at least four offensive fouls. They're limiting some of their players' minutes in that first half. Mentioned not an excuse for the Mustangs. Alicia Froling only played 6 minutes in that first half, but the rest of her teammates able to pick up the slack. Had a chance to hear from Travis Mays going in the locker room, and Austin is now joined by Temple Owls head coach Tanya Cardoza before we start the second half.
Coach, Aaliyah Butts got 9 shots off but only has 2 points. What was the conversation like in the locker room as you look to get her scoring more this half?
Well, she got shots. It's not just about Aaliyah scoring. It's about our team and how we look on offense. But more importantly, when we're not scoring, we got to do a better job defensively. And we gave up, 32 points to them. So that's a little bit too much for the first half.
Thank you, Coach.
Awesome. Thank you. Mia Davis and Aaliyah Butts played every minute of that first half. Both these teams really just limited it to about an 8-player rotation. Angela, when you take a look at some of the stats, obviously points off turnovers, 9 turnovers for Temple leading to 10 points there for the Mustangs.
Well, the predictability was in the rebounding. We knew that the Mustangs were going to out-rebound the Owls. But I guess the points in the paint were surprising because you thought Davis would actually mandate the paint. And I think really not having Butts in the offense for Temple has really been critical for them.
When we come back, third quarter getting underway between Mia Davis and Temple in Dallas on the road tonight. Dominance for a fourth straight year. Queso from 30.
Unbelievable.
And be able to celebrate the 7th championship.
There's the record breaker. They are the champions of the American.
More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination. At the American, we know that power isn't for the faint of heart. Power is reserved for the go-getters, the team players, and those who are hungry for victory. We know power because we are power. Join us for the 2019 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship, March 8th through the 11th at the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut.
Well, again, Temple getting 9 points from Mia Davis in that first half to go with 4 rebounds, as Tanya Cardoza mentioned. She and Aaliyah are both getting looks. Now, Aaliyah's shots just haven't been falling, but they do need some other Temple players to step up to help get a comeback going. They trailed by as many as 16 in that first half, down by 15 when we start the third quarter. A reminder, we'll shift directions and start crowning champions in the American. In our next couple of broadcasts, we'll head to Birmingham for the Indoor Track and Field Championships at the Birmingham Crossplex. That'll be this Friday and Saturday. And then next week, up in Indianapolis, site of this year's swimming and diving championships. Always great. Both those championships were so special. There's just so many student athletes in those two sports representing all the members of the American. Great to see all of them shine one final time with championships on the line, both individually and as teams collectively. So Lincoln Rose, Angela Beck, Austin Ivan with you, and the Mustangs, well, come out of the locker room, and it's White able to connect. She's got 6 points now for the ball game. Kayla White.
Not a good start for Temple. I think they're going to need to mix up their defenses a bit and be less predictable to the young team of SMU. SMU can't just get their rhythm like they are.
Well, this is deja vu. How many charging calls did we see particularly against Temple in that first quarter? And SMU able to find a shot to fall. Now their largest lead at 17, and they get the turnover on the other end.
Well, Jaquia White, there she was. She just she got jacked up in a pick and took one in the chin.
Really needs to be a stat. You don't get credit for a steal, but you do force the turnover. By the way, a rejuvenated Alicia Froling, who sat the final 14 minutes of the first half with two fouls.
Well, credit Mackenzie Ellis. I like the fire that she's bringing to the team.
And Temple able to answer. It's a rare chance for us to mention Imani Mayo today, just the way things have been going. A really bright young woman now in her sophomore year. Had her career high 20 points against SMU last year. Ellis to Cash. And again, that hasn't been a part of her game. She's now 2 of 14 on the year. A couple of misses today from downtown.
Yeah, but when it gets down to the time that's going to really count, don't count her out. She's the kind of kid that's going to stick one when it hurts.
Trying to work it inside here. That is the freshman, Jaquia White, who is defending Aaliyah Butts. And another offensive foul, this time Mackenzie Ellis stepping in.
Well, that's quite remarkable that I think that's the sixth offensive or fifth or sixth offensive charge that they have created.
Cash had 5 points in that first half. Ellis off the mark. Again, for the Mustangs, both Ellis and Froling with two fouls. For Temple, Mackins is playing with three. Taylor and Davis each with a pair of fouls as well. Mackins called for one of those offensive fouls earlier here in this third quarter. Davis and John Asia Cash intervening. Well, when we look at SMU, obviously tonight against Temple, they'll have a road trip to New Orleans after this, host Memphis on senior night, and then finish the regular season in Greenville at ECU. This team can take some strides and build some confidence going into next year when most of the team will be sophomores. Travis Mays will just have a couple of spots on the roster that he'll be looking to fill. Obviously a big one with Alicia Froling departing after 5 years. Temple could use more of that. Mackins playing with three fouls, able to drill one.
Well, a little adjustment that they made, though, from Temple is they put Butts at the point guard and moved Mackins to the two guard, and that freed her up to get a couple shots here, and I like that adjustment. Since Butts hasn't been hitting, why not go to Mackins?
They're looking for Froling. And they say that she lifted that left foot.
Yeah, it seems like right now SMU's pressing a little bit. They're making one or two passes and try to shoot it from long range or whatever. I mean, that's not the great shot for Froling either. They need to keep with their rhythm that they had in the first half and keep doing what they did to build the lead.
You know, we talked turnovers for Temple in that first half, but SMU just had one fewer turnover in that first half. They just had everything else going their way. And Froling, who on one end turns it over, gets the ball back. And how about Well, we talk about the proverbial collision of Aaliyah Bunce and Alicia Froling, the 2 5-year standouts. This time they meet in the post.
Well, I guess they haven't gotten that memo. They got the other memo, but this memo is you can't penetrate versus SMU tonight. They're definitely going to take the charge and get their body squared up.
Again, really two great student-athletes, Aaliyah Bunce and Alicia Froling. Last time we get to see them collide here on the American Digital Network. They've helped define these programs over the past several years. Alicia Froling stepped in again as a freshman with her presence as a 6'3", really a guard defender on the perimeter, which has helped her really average about 50 block shots every year and rewrite the records at SMU. Back then, she arrived as a freshman with her twin Keely and, of course, Stephanie Collins, also from Australia at the time. It's 6'5". Some great signs for Rhonda Rompola and now Travis Mays.
Yeah, I mean, holding the records in rebounding and blocks and then also being number 5 in scoring with 1,482 points. It doesn't matter what she does this year. Doesn't matter how they end up. That's a great player, and she's made a great impact on SMU.
The problem is she's been too good. So coming into this year, when people knew she was back with the young group, she is always the game plan to try to slow her down. Meanwhile, the constant tonight has been Ja'Kia White fighting for every basketball in her zip code.
Well, absolutely. And also now you see Temple kind of loosening up and starting to rock and fire from three-point. This was a little fight here, but lost by SMU.
I'll say Davis was able to knock it off of White to keep this one for Temple. They got a fresh shot clock out of it. Didn't need the full 30 seconds. Lena Neon on the money.
Well, she's a silent killer right there. She just comes in precarious situations and nails one.
Cash into Froling every time.
You know, it makes me happy to see her, you know, be able to score inside like that and get that touch pass. She's such a great finisher around the rim. She has great touch, you know, with her hands and the ball. And, I mean, just a quick little loopy shot there, but she's a finisher.
And to make things worse, Mia Davis picks up her third foul in that transaction. Davis is going to stay in.
Well, I think in order for SMU, and I say this even though they have this lead, but in order for them to win the game, I'd keep attacking Davis because she's such a big player for them. If they can go low and get that fourth foul on her, that would be huge.
Alicia Froling's been limited to 3 shots, but she's made all 3 of them now for her 7 points. That ball tracked down by Whitfield, waits for some reinforcements. Cash double teamed. Froling trying to give her a little bit of breathing room. And then John Asia tries to tie it back up, but this will stay with Temple.
Well, Temple needs to up their intensity level a little bit because SMU has come to play, and their intensity level is at, like, a 5.
Travis Mays mentioned he was going to, first he said congratulate, but he realized they were just halfway through this game. But he wanted to reemphasize the things that SMU was doing well so they would remember what got them that lead in the first half.
Well, that's a great comment because he's a positive coach. He's had some lumps this year. It's been hard for him, but he's still, you know, coaching positively.
Well, early on, he realized Alicia was going to essentially be your leader on the court, but he couldn't put the burden of 7 true freshmen on her. So he said he was going to be the leader in the locker room and trying to work with all this youth, a team that averaged 19 years of age at the start of the season. Lincoln Rose, along with Angela Beck, and another chance here during this timeout to check back in with Austin Ivan.
Thanks, Lincoln. Senior Alicia Froling holds the all-time record at SMU for most blocks, rebounds, and double-doubles. She's also the only SMU women's basketball player to record 1,000-plus points and 1,000-plus rebounds. Our trivia question to you is, how many players in SMU basketball history, both men's and women's combined, have ever had 1,000-plus points and 1,000-plus rebounds in their career? Let us know in the comments below if you think you know the answer to how many players have done that. And later on in the game, we'll give you the correct answer.
Austin, thank you. When we come back, we'll answer the initial trivia question about Mia Davis and how many times she has had 20 or more points this year. They'll need another big night from her, needing a comeback against SMU here in Dallas.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle, a big save, a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
For a fourth straight year. Cueto from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate the seventh championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Well, we mentioned just about everything going SMU's way. Right now up by 14, still with the lead here midway in the third quarter. Mustangs, 12 assists on 16 made field goals tonight.
Well, they've been sharing the basketball incredibly, and it starts with Ellis. She has really come into her own, and I can see him creating things around her. There's a little flip pass back to Froehling, and she's just really been all over the court and finding the open man.
Conversely, Temple, Aaliyah Butts with 5 assists tonight. Probably would have more, but she and her teammates have struggled to hit some from the floor. They have just 9 field goals, 7 assists on those 9 field goals. Butts at the line.
Yeah, I think the problem right now is Butts really needs to score, just because when she scores, it gives them a lot of adrenaline, and she hasn't found her way yet. So this is good that she's got a couple at the line, but I think she needs to take the ball aggressively to the hole, get a couple easy twos, and then her three game will come.
Aaliyah's the number 3 all-time scorer, over 1,800 points at Temple. She's probably going to finish her career at number 2, surpassing her former teammate Atkinson.
Well, this is what I expected Coach Cardoza to bring a three-quarter court press out and look for this press to be early and often now until the remainder of the game.
Ellis, no-look pass into a crowded area and a break for SMU. 3 on the shot clock, still get off a good look. It scrapes the rim, but they're going to say just net. Okay, shot clock violation.
Yeah, if Whitfield's shot would have gone down, that would have been a dagger right there. Tough, tough shot, because they had a really good defensive possession going.
So Temple again down by Baker's dozen. Trailed by as many as 19. And again, inching closer and closer. Add another 2 to the resume of the freshman, Alexa Williamson.
Yeah, just good overall look there.
4 Owls there were collapsing at midcourt on Ja'Kia White.
SMU has not been known for their press breaking tactics. They struggle normally because they have so many bigs in. It's not that easy for them to get it down.
Ellis, rolling with the rebound, adds to her career lead at SMU. Mustangs haven't scored in over 2 minutes, allowing Temple to pull back within 11 now. Cash able to shake free of Mackins, but forgot the basketball.
Well, that's a vacuum cleaner kind of snatch by Butts.
Neon for 3. Looking for her 3rd of the ball game.
Just not shooting well. I mean, those are good looks, and looks that they usually get.
Kenzie Ellis, both feet behind the line. Froehling with the offensive board.
Well, it's her home court, and the end of her career here, you better be blocking her out.
3-minute drought. SMU's made just 1 of its last 7 shots from the floor. Ellis, a little pump fake. And that ball stripped away by Aaliyah Butts. Nobody has more steals in Tipple history, the number zero.
She has 5 steals in this game already.
And the Mustangs are going to slow things down. Getting their lead down to 11. Freshman on freshman out there on the perimeter. Froling liked the odds after she was able to shed half of the double team. Final 2 minutes here in the third quarter. Temple with some positives to look back at if they can continue to cut into this deficit. Nice job, just couldn't finish there from Williamson.
Yeah, both teams getting a lot of good looks there. Quality shots at the bucket, in the paint, and just not converting.
Cash. And that time blocked cleanly by Alexa Williamson. And free throws coming up.
That's called a 1-2 vision punch there where Butts sees Davis in the middle of the court. She wouldn't throw that pass to probably anybody else but her because it's a dangerous pass, and Davis takes it.
So Mia Davis, 9 points in the first half, still hasn't scored here in the second half. Does have 5 rebounds, a couple of assists at the line. 73% free throw shooter. And coming off her most recent double-double, 11 times this year, the answer to the trivia question, that Mia Davis has 20 or more points. She's finished with 10 or more in 22 of Temple's 23 games this year, and averaging almost 20 points, 10 rebounds a night. 10 double-doubles on the year for Davis, and again, they need more from her, even despite the great effort so far. And they get a walk on Tolley.
Well, that's what SMU has to be concerned about. There's still a minute left in the quarter, and they have to take their time against that press and not try to press it and get turnovers like that, because that's exactly what, that's feeding off what Temple wants them to do.
So Tanya Cardoza's group has trimmed it down to a 3-possession ball game. They trailed by as many as 19. That has been shaved down to 9 as SMU in the midst of a 4.5-minute drought. And again, Temple, that win against Cincinnati, a big part of it was a 12-0 run in the fourth quarter. If they could put together something like that, all of a sudden the Owls are winners of 6 of their last 7 ball games here in conference play.
Well, the Owls have been their own worst enemy as far as how they've operated. And I think if they can just get a couple series here together, they're in the game here. That's Mackins off the inbounds. Good play where she just kind of rotates off the weak side and gets that short corner.
7-point ball game. It's a 15-7 third quarter for Temple.
First time I've seen a little 2-3 zone now, so they're mixing up their defense. And it's causing them not to have the rhythm that they had in the first 3 quarters.
And our officials are glued to those kicks. They saw the pivot foot come up.
This is what's really hard for a team like SMU, a team that's lost several games in a row. You've lost your confidence. Even though you have this lead, now you start to second-guess yourself, and you don't really have the fluidity that you need. So they need to keep the pressure on, and they need to be aggressive still and not be hesitant.
Temple with a chance to make this a 2-score ball game going into the fourth quarter. They've held SMU to just 7 points here since coming out of the locker room. Butts trying to draw some contact, won't get it. Davis the putback, no. And that is your third period of play. Temple closes it out on a 7-0 run. Shuts SMU down over the last 5.5 minutes without a score. And it's the Owls battling back within seven to start the fourth quarter when we come back.
Power comes in all forms.
Power is a big tackle,
a big save,
a clutch hit,
or a game-winning shot.
Power is also standing up for what is right.
There is power in the sportsmanship that is displayed across the American.
Power is respecting opponents,
officials,
student athletes,
coaches, and team representatives.
Power is not tolerating racial or ethnic comments,
profanities, or other improper actions while at the game.
The American.
Power for life.
The American. Power for life.
The American.
Power for life.
At The American, we know that power isn't for the faint of heart. Power is reserved for the go-getters, the team players, and those who are hungry for victory. We know power because we are power. Join us for the 2019 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship, March 8th through the 11th at the Mohegan Sun Arena in Uncasville, Connecticut. More than 7,000 student athletes rising to become champions in 22 different sports at 13 esteemed institutions across 11 states. 360,000 students and 2.6 million alumni rise up in celebration of a Power Six conference known as the American, powered by determination.
Three quarters in the books, Mustangs still with a lead, but a 19-point advantage has been trimmed down to seven by Temple as they close out the third quarter on a 7-0 run. And Angela, the reason why there are people starting to inch closer and closer to us with bubble wrap is, well, they're about to pack us up until next women's basketball season. Our schedule for women's hoops here in the American about to wrap up. We'll be shifting gears to championship coverage here on ADN before going into the spring sports again. This weekend, Friday and Saturday, live coverage from Birmingham, Alabama of the Indoor Track and Field Championships. And then starting midweek next week, the Swimming and Diving Championships up in Indianapolis. But we still have at least 10 more minutes of American hoops here on ADN, as this is starting to get tighter than the Mustangs had hoped for. Let's see which of these two fifth-year seniors can help guide their team to a victory tonight.
Well, credit SMU so far. They put a great game plan together. They've got Temple 43 points under what they've been scoring lately. So they're probably not going to pick that up in this quarter. So they've got them playing their game. They got them in a slowdown offense. They got Leah Butts covered, which is a big deal. And their game plan's been really solid.
No Mustang in double figures. Alicia Froling, despite sitting 14 of the first 20 minutes of this ball game, is your leading Mustang with 7 points. Mia Davis, the only player in double figures for either team, a turnover here. As Davis with 11 points, just 2 in that third quarter after 9 in her first half.
Well, coach going with the two bigs inside with Froling and Bayless. So he's wanting to pound it inside. They just had an inadvertent turnover there, which was...
Cash back in for Bayless. Cash tonight, 5 points, 9 rebounds, leading rebounder for either team this evening. Kenzie Ellis also back in with 7 boards. Again, Temple early in the fourth quarter in that Cincinnati comeback win had a 12-0 run. A lot of it was Aaliyah Butts, who had 11 points in that quarter. But the Owls with Neon able to connect for a third time from downtown.
Like I called her the silent killer. She's the one that's just kind of lurking around, and she's nailing it. Got to cover her.
The second foul called on Williamson. Screen for Froling. Thought she could draw a defensive foul around the restricted arc, and now she was favoring it, looked like, that left leg.
That one hurts. I'm going to tell you what, she is one tough cookie. She's not a kid that's going to... Oh, wow.
So that's going to go down as, again, her first foul since sitting with two in the first quarter. And you see that left ankle.
Yeah.
And she steps on the defender's foot.
Well, I don't know if high top tennies would have done a difference, but I was a high top tenny coach. I wouldn't let them do anything but have high tops on and also have them taped because I just didn't want that to happen. But I don't know if it would have stopped it.
Alicia heading back to the locker room, meaning Travis Mays right now just has seven players that have seen action tonight available to him. And during all of this, Temple has cut it down to a four-point ball game.
Coach Mays is like, what else can happen to me? I mean, I'm doing my best. I'm coaching them up.
Tale of two halves.
Give me a break.
Mia Davis, your leading scorer in this ball game, the only player in double figures right now with 11. Her only scores in the second half have been at the free throw line. Now 3 points in this half.
Unfortunately, SMU's turnovers, they've got 17 turnovers all of a sudden, and you know, that's up to 13 turnovers for Temple, and that's the big game changer. This press that they put on in the middle of this third quarter has really changed the complexion of the game.
SMU needs a score desperately.
They haven't gotten in their offense yet, and there's 13 seconds left on the clock.
And this will stay with the Mustangs with a fresh shot clock. That 19-point lead is down to the final 2 points. As Temple trying to complete a comeback has outscored the Mustangs this half 22-7. Cash, a long two, no. And the rebound for Davis. Seventh board now for Davis. Chance to tie or maybe even take a lead here. Wide open, off the glass. Owls have the lead. Marissa Mackins able to strike.
Wow. Don't know if the bank was called, but what a shot.
Her second triple.
She's a very confident shooter.
It's a 20-point turnaround for the Owls. And they're about to get it back.
As she gets her feet set and just launches it, looks like she actually...
A geometry major.
Went after that corner rim.
Went off that 12-point outing against Cincinnati the other night. Has 9 points now. Aaliyah Butts, who's 1-for-11. How much you want to bet she catches fire all of a sudden just to start rubbing it in? She gets back, tries to affect things without committing the foul, but the Mustangs are back in the driver's seat for the moment.
A much-needed shot by White. She's been shut down here lately, and that's a good offensive transition bucket.
Aaliyah Butts, 7 assists tonight. Works it inside. Denied assist number 8 was looking for Williamson. And Tanya Cardoza is going to go to her bench. We're going to have an official timeout with 7 minutes to go, just about here in the fourth quarter. Well, it's just what you expected, right? Temple had erased the deficit, but it's SMU back up by 1.
Discovery. It can come from any direction, in places new and familiar, but often starts from within.
I was the last person anybody's thinking is going to be in college athletics. One thing I really valued about my SMU experience was being in engineering school. I was taught how to think. In 2012, my wife and I decided to start our foundation. Basically, the goal is to let kids be kids while they're in the hospital, but also be able to return to being a kid when they're done. A huge part of my quality of life is the experiences that I've had, and that was all provided by SMU. I'm Thomas Morstead. Game changers are shaped here.
dominance for a fourth straight year.
Queso from 30!
Unbelievable!
And be able to celebrate this type of championship.
There's the record breaker! They are the champions of the American.
Alicia Froehling back out of the locker room. Ready to give it a go here down the stretch. Again, she is the only women's player ever to have 1,000 rebounds, as well as 1,000 points. Well, but again, this second half, it's been about things clicking for Temple, including the shots from downtown.
Well, Mackins, she shows she's got ice in her veins. And then you got Neon. I mean, she's just in the corner. No one knows she's there, and she just silently just fires it up, and she's got good rhythm, great touch. I don't think she's even hit the rim tonight.
Nina Neon with three triples. Mackins hitting her second right there off the glass at the time to give Temple a 40-39 lead, their first advantage since trailing by 19. SMU has answered with the most recent score, a layup from White. But back underway, Temple with the basketball, a chance to inch back ahead in the final 7 minutes here of regulation.
Well, you need a team that scored 75 points in the last few outings, seven outings. They weren't going to be silent the whole game, and now they find their rhythm a little bit. So it's not too late, though. SMU just needs to sharpen up the D.
We'll point out Froehling is not back in the game yet. Temple is back in the driver's seat, up by one.
A little isolation for Mia Davis. Great call from the bench.
How will this young Mustangs group handle this adversity here late? The elder statesman out there is Ellis, the junior. White goes inside, can't hit the bunny.
A little bit too much juke and jive on that.
And now Temple happy to take their time for the moment. Oh, Aaliyah Butts finds Davis, but it's their old friend from the first half, the charging call.
Well, Coach must have seen something in Temple, but that's a tough call there. But, you know, great defense, great.
Ja'Kia White takes the charge.
Yeah, she's had several this game.
Mentioned Froehling on the bench, the only women's player at SMU ever to have 1,000 points, 1,000 boards in her career. Only two men's players at SMU, including Ira Terrell, have ever accomplished as much.
Great take there by Cash. You know, Cash came early in the half, and really you could tell she was a major leader, and then she's been a little bit silent here in the second half. So I like that take, and she drew the foul and got to the line. Stopped the bleeding.
So John Asia looking for points 6 and 7, a 9-rebound outing today. Still haven't seen Alicia back on the floor since heading back to the locker room and returning with the ankle concerns. Davis back to the bench. Davis still the only player for either team in double digits, 15 points, 7 rebounds. She picked up her fourth foul a moment ago. Tanya Cardoza trying to save her for crunch time, if this isn't already crunch time.
Yeah, just two important free throws there that were missed.
Butts with the crossover. Well, she only made one of her first 11, but it's what have you done for me recently that counts the most, and she drains that one.
Well, she hasn't done a lot on the offensive end, but those 5 steals and 7 assists sure do count.
One cousin to another, both of them off the mark.
Well, I think I feel it a little bit unraveling in the fact that you've got this graduate student, you know, kind of controlling things on this end, and she knows how it's supposed to be played. Look at that, splitting the defenders. Oh, hello.
Again, Aaliyah Butts put up 11 points in the fourth quarter alone against Cincinnati in their last outing. Part of a big comeback for Temple. And all of a sudden, she has more points here in the first half of the fourth quarter than the entire ball game coming into this final frame.
It doesn't seem fair that she just kind of waits this long.
Ellis in for a closer look, denied. Flat-footed by Neon, as well as Shantae Taylor, who is again held back early with fouls in this one.
Well, 6-0 run now. for Temple. They're starting to build a little lead here, and it's critical that SMU get a stop here.
Owls have made their last three shots. And you almost expected that one to go down. Cash will tap it out, but it just means a fresh shot clock for Mackins and Temple.
I was surprised early on that there weren't a lot of pick and rolls for Butts. And that's the first pick and roll I've seen all day. I mean, now they're just going to put the ball in the star's hands and put it in the post player's hand, I was going to say, but that didn't happen.
They'll cough it up, never get a second chance opportunity. Midfield drives. It won't go. Let's check in with Austin, courtside.
Thanks, Lincoln. As the game's winding down, we want to know who you think the MVP of the game should be. Let us know in the comments below who you think deserves to be the MVP, and after the game, we will interview them.
First, you need to be a bit of a psychic to know how this one's going to play out. Still very much within doubt, but we welcome your suggestions. I know we have family members of current Mustangs, current Owls, as well as some future players in the American tuning in. A good one developing here late. It's a game that SMU led by as many as 19, but in the second half, they've been outscored 29-9. Again, Lincoln Rose, Angela Beck with you, along with a former D1 hoopster in her own right, Austin. And let's check back in with Austin.
Thanks, Lincoln. Head coach for SMU, Travis Mays, decided to do something new at the beginning of this season. He wanted to start a book club for his team. So at the beginning of the season, he made his team read the book, The Energy Bus, and they just finished that. They're now onto the book, Chop Wood, Carry Water. Now, Coach Mays doesn't just make his team read these books. After they finish it, he has them break into groups and do a book report to the rest of their team on the books. Coach Mays said he's really think this has helped him with the team building and their leadership.
Austin, thank you. You know, it's been a long season. Was it SMU that had the t-shirts that said get on the bus, or was that another team? The Energy Bus is a book that's been going around here for these squads. Again, you and I are lucky to talk to all these coaches, hear all these stories. But now some of them are starting to blend together.
No, yeah, I'm not real sure about the answer to that, Lincoln. Maybe they would make that our trivia question. We should maybe use that as a trivia question.
But again, what a run it's been once again here on the American Digital Network and wherever you may be tuning in from. Lincoln Rose, Angela Beck with you. A big thanks to our entire crew. We are fortunate every year. The coaches in this league, so much collective knowledge, and they're willing to share it, whether we're calling them during the week or getting to talk like Austin is at halftime with both of them. Certainly look forward to next year, but there's still a lot to develop over this final month of conference play and then the conference tournament in Connecticut.
They've been absolutely fantastic, as has the American Athletic Conference and our American Digital Network, and obviously you, Lincoln. It's been a lot of fun.
Appreciate it again. We're at crunch time here between SMU and the Owls, and both teams with some highs and lows here. And right now a 6-0 run for Temple over the past 3.5 minutes. With about 3.5 still to go.
Well, we knew it was going to be a game. We knew at some point the Owls were not going to lay down, and it has become a game. Now, can SMU find a way and the will to win with Alicia Frawling still sitting on the bench?
Both head coaches have surrounded themselves with great staffs.
Yeah, it doesn't look to me like Alicia's going to be able to get back in from what I saw.
Well, this isn't normal, but frankly, tonight the box score has looked better when she has been on the bench. I don't think that's something you would count on regularly, but there's been something about in her absence, this team knows everybody needs to pick up the slack.
Yeah, correct. It becomes more of a five people trying to do something.
Davis still able to collect that ball, bobbled it, and able to score.
Well, just take note that one thing that they're doing outstandingly, or is that a word, for Temple is Butts and Davis. It's those two guys making it happen. And that's called controlling who scores for your team, and that's what Cardova's doing. She's making sure her major players have the ball in their hands late in the game.
So SMU trying to end a 4.5 minute scoring drought. And that's just the way the second half of this ball game's gone now, it feels like. Kayla White with one more free throw to go. Kayla, as a freshman, 22 starts in 24 games this year. And they're going to say she left the line prematurely, so that negates the bucket.
Well, Kayla White, that's not great, but she's really been tremendous this year. I mean, for her to put up the numbers she's put up and really be the go-to on this team as a freshman, my hat's off to her. She's had an outstanding freshman year.
In a 26-point turnaround now for Temple, up by 7. I mean, we literally just saw something we don't see very often. You make a free throw, and it's wiped off the board because the shooter entered the lane. It's the right call, obviously. And now here you have the benefit of the veteran point guard slowing things down. And her calm demeanor, contagious. And Davis, the offensive rebound, put back and draws the foul.
I'm not so sure that wasn't actually a call play where they actually go to the other post player and then try to get Davis on the weak side to rebound the basketball. That's Taylor. Taylor was the one on the weak, strong side, and Davis cleaned it up.
Mia Davis has 19 points, 8 rebounds in this one. She is still the only player in double digits tonight, now with 20.
Well, it's kind of like Temple knows how to turn it up when they need to, and that's what they proved.
A rough first half. Temple only had 7 points in that second quarter after a 10-point first quarter. But now a 34-9 advantage in the second half. Ellis, both feet behind the line, good. That ends a 5-minute drought for SMU. After a 5.5-minute drought to close the third quarter. Temple again trying to win its 6th game over its last 7 contests after it had entered this stretch only winning 4 games all year. And now a foot race and another layup miss from Kayla White.
Oh, that one hurts.
All of a sudden a 3-pointer from Temple makes it a double-digit lead for the Owls. Inside the final 90 seconds. And there's block number 201 in the career of Elisa Froehlich. Ja'Kia White throws one up. It'll go through and it's a 2-score ball game.
Well, that's a great block by one of the great blockers in the American and the best blocker in SMU women's basketball history to put him back in it.
Well, this one's not over yet. 71 seconds in regulation. 5-point ball game. SMU will hope to force a turnover coming out of this timeout. Something they've been able to do. 16 turnovers by Temple tonight, 18 for the Mustangs.
Yeah, great play by Ja'Kia White just to go in and get it to the rim and get that 2 points. Now look for them to extend their defense and try to get a turnover here. They've got a few possessions left, and it's a two-possession game.
See Amy Smith-Bradley, the former Texas Longhorn player, assistant for Travis Mays. A little homecoming for her when she took the job a few years back. Her grandfather and dad both played football for SMU.
Butts is a 73% shooter. Look for the ball to be in her hand or Davis's hand most of the series.
Davis being told she can run the baseline. Pressure from the Mustangs. Final minute in the fourth quarter. Temple trailed by 19 at one point in this ball game. Right now, a five-point advantage, and that's probably not the foul they were looking for, as committing it is Jakia White.
Yeah, you just would have hoped that that would have been a little earlier than it is in the shot clock.
That is her fourth. Only Mustang with four fouls.
Especially with four fouls.
Yeah, Davis is playing with four fouls. Shantae Taylor, who's been limited tonight, is on the bench with four. Aaliyah Butts, a 73% free throw shooter. Next foul by the Mustangs would lead to free throws. No need. Ellis forces the turnover. White goes straight to the rim. Aaliyah Butts wisely did not risk committing a foul. And White comes through on the layup, and this will stay with Temple for now.
Well, talk about learning from your mistakes. White missed that layup the last time. She went and did a nice jump stop pump fake and made sure she made that layup.
Now it's SMU with a 7-0 run. That's been over just the past minute and a half.
I was kind of certain that he would foul earlier than that, but they just got the steal and turned it up court for the layup. That's picture-perfect defense there by SMU.
You saw Houston force overtime earlier today against Temple and then prevail in overtime. See how this one plays out here in Dallas.
Yeah, there's a steal by Jaquia White, and she's up to her cousin there for the layup.
Aaliyah Butts, again, wisely did not concede a three-point play opportunity. Well, no, with that layup, there's finally a Mustang in double-digit scoring, Kayla White. Mackenzie Ellis helped force the turnover a moment ago. Applies the pressure here. Mackins, the freshman. And a timeout, Tanya Cardoza, before that ball gets officially tied up by SMU. That should leave each team with one timeout left.
Kind of surprised they didn't get an early foul on that, being down three with less than 30 to go. I would try to put the pressure on them to make their free throws. It's still a three-point game. Now they're going to have to foul them if they can't get the steal on the inbounds here. But excellent game by both teams. Temple on the road, they've had difficult time on the road this year. And they have potential with the remainder of their season to close out really strong, because they're at Memphis, they've got Wichita, Tulsa. They've got some games that they're capable of winning. At UCF might be a tough one, but other than that, they've got winnable games to put themselves in command here down the stretch.
Oddly enough, Lena Neon this year has not shot a single free throw. We'll see who SMU tries to allow a pass into. Temple has to call a timeout there to avoid the five count. And I think that's it for Temple in terms of timeouts.
That's a good point, Lincoln. Putting a player in there that's never been to the line it's a tough scenario, because I would like to foul her quickly, but I'm pretty sure she won't be touching it. But SMU then, you almost hope at this point of the season, when they've had such a tough road. But, you know, nothing's easy, and good things take time. And just because you're losing games, it's not losing a game. It's how you learn from it. And I feel like they've got so much to build on, and they've got a great coach. They've got a great program. They've got really good young talent that I think is going to carry them, and I can see them starting to stand out. And so their future is bright, and I think he's doing a great job building that program.
You see the difference in the two clocks. Just about every player on the court right now for Temple is a 73% free throw shooter or better, with the exception of Lena Neon, who simply has not had an attempt coming off the bench every game this year, with except for one.
Well, you've got to get a steal or a foul immediately.
They'll get into Mack, and she's their best free throw shooter, and it's poked loose by SMU. Looking for the tie. Brand new ball game.
What? Oh, my gosh.
Reed Tolley was dancing dangerously close to that three-point line. I'm not sure if they will look at it, but at the moment it's a three and we are even 51-51.
Well, what a great poke from behind. She just steps up and drains it. Now here, they don't need to foul. They've got a tie game and they foul Butts.
And that's just some inexperience.
And I'm sure he's like, no, no, no.
Aaliyah today, 1 of 2 from the free throw line, 73% shooter on the year. And we're still tied for the moment. But this means any kind of score from SMU potentially could give them the win if they can deny Temple a rebound. Butts will try to hit it for the lead. Aaliyah Butts' 8th point of the night is her biggest.
Well, good timeout now to bring the ball to half court and set up your offense. I don't know. It's your call. I mean, like, anyone can do. I mean, who would have thought they're going to pull up and Bree Tolley's going to take a three when she's shooting 7 of 21 for the season.
Bree Tolley winds up with the ball in her lap after they forced the turnover. So, McKenzie Ellis now twice here down the stretch has forced a couple of turnovers without having to commit a foul.
She has, and that's how it unfolded right there by her stepping up and then shooting that big. That's a huge three. Lots of guts for that three.
Holly realized they needed a three to tie at the time. She is 2 for 3 from downtown today, and both feet, yes, were behind the line.
And then when they get it in bounds, they just put her to the line. I think you go down low to your all everything.
Got to get a shot off. Any field goal will win it. Too easy. Ariana Whitfield goes straight to the rim. Will Butts get a shot off in time? SMU ball. The Mustangs are going to win this one. Ariana Whitfield went uncontested for the layup.
Incredible, incredible. Her burst of energy, I don't think anyone expected her to just go and take it to the rim like she did, because she hasn't all game. And then she just did it on the defensive end too. What an incredible finish for SMU.
Mustangs close it out on a 12-1 run, including a giant three-pointer from Bree Tolley at the time to tie it. And Ariana Whitfield with the game-winning layup. Just her 5th and 6th points of the ball game.
Well, that's pure joy when you look at a team that's lost 5 in a row and you dig one out like that against a good team like Temple. And then you have a great player like Alicia Frawling.
All right, let's check in with Austin Ivan, who's with one of your heroes of this one.
You guys are down 3 points. You get a steal, you come down, you could shoot a layup, but you go for the three, you knock it down. Just take me through that possession.
Before we came out, Coach asked 4 of us to shoot the three. It was me, Kenzie, Kayla, and I, right? And so he said, if we get the steal, find a spot on the three-point line and just shoot it, and that's exactly what I did.
When you shot it, did you know it was going in right when you released it?
Yes, I got confidence in my shot.
You guys were up by as many as 19. Temple came back, battled back into it. How were you able to withstand the run and finish off the game?
Just doing our job and applying what Coach says. Just doing what Coach says.
Great win tonight.
Wow.
Coach, great win. Hectic ending. Take me through that last timeout when you call a timeout and you drop a play.
Well, I knew I had 3 options. I know Bree Tolley can shoot the ball really, really well. I think that most people, when you run a sideline out of bounds at the end of the game, they forget about the inbounder. So I told Ariana, I said, are you ready to win it? She said, yes. I said, okay, first I'm going to look at Alicia. If they take it away, don't throw it to the post. Throw it to Bree, go get it, and go score. Because they don't want to foul, you take it right to the basket. And here we are with the win.
You only have 8 healthy players, but by halftime, every single one had scored already. How much easier does it make your job when you can draw up a play like that and have confidence any single one of your girls can score?
Well, I've been saying that all year. If they just execute and they give their best effort to try and listen and apply, it makes coaching a whole lot easier. That's the most difficult part of our job, is to get them to listen and apply. They did a good job of it tonight, not a great job. I think in the second half they were satisfied the way they played the first half, but I'm glad they continued to fight.
Great win, Coach.
Thank you very much.
Austin, thank you. It's a game where SMU led by as many as 19, then trailed by as many as 10. They go on a 12-1 run. We see Mackenzie Ellis with two of her three steals down the stretch. Of course, Bree Tolley knocking down the three and the game-winning layup from Ariana Whitfield. You heard Austin talk about it there with Travis Mays, a total team effort.
Absolutely. A joy to watch.
What a game for us to go out on. Still a couple weeks left here of American competition. A lot can still happen. But a sincere thanks to all of our gang, including Carl, Dustin, Iggy, Martin, and Scott. For Angela Beck, Austin Ivan, I'm Lincoln Rose. The Mustangs victorious 53-52. And a win they will likely never forget, as SMU back in the win column here in Dallas. And best of luck to both the Owls and Mustangs moving on as they march towards the conference tournament in Connecticut.